In a previous video, I had talked about why I had such a problem with number bonds. And there was a good discussion around number bonds, and it prompted me to want to talk to you about an alternative to number bonds. I'm Christina Tondevold, and I hope that you will stick around as we investigate an alternative to number bonds as we work to build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. So as you can see from my image here, it might be giving you a little bit of a hint as to what direction we're going. But I just want to give a little reminder in case you did not watch the full video, and I'll link to it under this video, about my issue with number bonds. This is what number bonds look like. And really, it can have any number in that spot there, but this example is with fractions, and the idea is that 3/4 is the whole, and then it can be broken into two parts, or you might even have more than that. You could have three parts, four parts, it doesn't matter, right? But the problem I have here is that it doesn't, kids really struggle with how to put numbers in here, and it doesn't help kids out with knowing which circle is for the whole, right? Just because the lines connect them, our young kids especially don't understand it. So one of the suggestions was to make that whole circle bigger. But one of the issues still is that the other two circles, the parts, are still the same size, right? So to me, when I look at that, it makes me want to put the same amount into both of those circles because they are the same size. So one of my big issues with number bonds is they don't promote, I guess is the word I'm trying to think here, they don't promote proportionality. It doesn't help kids understand the magnitude of those parts. The model that I would like to encourage you to use as an alternative does. Some people call these bar models, strip diagrams, part-part whole models. They have lots of different terms. But the idea is that you use a rectangle to represent the whole, and then underneath or on top of, you put two rectangles that would create that whole. Or you could have more rectangles, but we start usually with two parts and work our way there. So on these examples that I shared in the previous video, right, it's just taking that idea and putting them into a rectangular format. This does a lot of things for our kids. Number one, it helps build proportionality. Just by looking at that, I can tell that one of the parts that makes the 7 needs to be a little bit bigger than the other part, right? And then I can talk with my students about what do you think these parts could be, okay? So I want to show you two videos. I recorded my kids at home because I have permission to record them. So they're always my video getting pigs. And I was able to get my son, who is in kindergarten. So he is a very early kindergarten kid. He's born in August. So he is only 5 years old and just turned 5 a month before kindergarten actually started. Now, let's just say he is not a normal kindergartner around mathematic thinking, because he does come from my household. So I do know that, but I wanted to show you how he thought about this model. He has never used this model before. He's a kindergartner. Okay, so keep all of that in mind. Here is what he did when I gave him a little worksheet that had these models.
There you go.
Okay.
That's an 8.
Uh-huh.
And then 2.
Ooh, because 8 and 2 makes
10.
10? Okay, what would you do on this one? Oh, I got a question for you. Why did you put a 1 here and the 9 there? It makes 10,
yeah.
You're right, but how come you put the 1 there?
Because this space is littler.
That space is littler? Yeah? Okay, what are you going to do on this one then?
There you go.
Oh my goodness, how come you did that?
Because
why?
Because 10 plus 0 makes 10.
Yeah, well, but why did you put 0 here?
Because it's a littler spot.
It's a little spot. That is great thinking, buddy.
Now again, remember, he is in the beginning of kindergartner, a young kindergartner who has never used the model before, and he instinctually knew what to put in there. Now, understand, granted, a lot of kindergartners don't know that 1 in 9 makes 10, all of that kind of stuff. I knew his mathematical capability, so I picked 10. I knew that he knew a lot of his number combinations that make 10. I wasn't trying to test him on the addition pieces. I just wanted to see what he would do with the model because he's never been exposed to that model. And he knew that the smaller piece there means that it should be a smaller number. The bigger chunk should be a larger quantity. That's the power of this model that we don't get in a number bond. That's one of the reasons why number bonds are so darn confusing for our kids. Yet these two models still incorporate the same mathematics and build the same thinking for our kids. But the part whole model of this bar model is way more beneficial, guys. I do understand that on the first one, he did not notice that they were the same size and he put an 8 and a 2. But I gotta remember, he's only 5. And then with the other ones, he did notice the size difference, and that helped him determine the quantities to put in there. Okay, now I took this to one of my older kids. Two of my kids don't like being on video, so they're hard to get on video. So I got these two kiddos. The other one you're gonna see is my daughter. She is a 4th grader. Again, this is taken in the fall of her 4th grade year. Okay. And again, I knew that she knew the math, the addition piece of this. I'm not testing on her combinations to 100. I really am just looking at, does she understand the model without ever having been exposed to this model? Here's her thinking.
Use these models before?
I don't think so.
What do you think this is showing? Like, what's your thought just looking at it?
Groups. Like, you can break 100 down into equal groups here, like 50 and 50, and this one's 70 and 30.
Okay, go 16 ahead and fill 40. It. Let's see. Okay. What do you think? Why'd you break that one into 50 and 50?
Because it looks split right here, like even.
Okay. What do you think you'd do? So then this one you said?
70 and 30.
How come 70 and 30?
Because this one looks like a lot smaller than this.
Okay. And same thing there.
Yeah.
You put a smaller amount, but not, so why is that one 40 this time? Like why?
Because this one is smaller than this one, and this one is a little bit smaller than this one.
Awesome.
And again, do you see it? Like instinctual, all I had to just say, like I just asked her, what do you think this model is showing? And she was able to understand the model without any instruction on my end. That's the power of a model, is that we want kids' own thinking to be able to come through. What they're thinking about should not be, what does this model even do? What do I do here? We want them to be thinking about the mathematics that they're putting into that model. That is super, super huge. And I gotta say that this model, the part whole bar model, whatever way you wanna call it, does that so much more than a number bond does. And that's the big thing, is that even our youngest kids, when you see that visual, it's telling you something about the size and magnitude of the numbers. And that to me is an awesome, awesome model, right? That even a kindergartner can instinctually understand it, right? Not all of your kindergartners are going to get it. I know that my kindergartner kiddo is a little bit different. You're going to use smaller numbers, all of that to start off with. But even just putting 3 in there and then having one that's smaller and one that's a little bit bigger and helping them understand that, you know, it's going to be a 1 and a 2 in there. And if you notice, I loved it. I know some people are going to ask this, like, I didn't say anything to him about how that one really couldn't be 0, right? Technically, he's really wrong in that model, because if it was 0, the 10 would be all the way out and there would be no space for a 0, right? Does that make sense? But in his mind, he knew it was small. Well, he had already used the other small amounts. In the first one, he used 8 and 2. Then he used the 1 in the middle one. And then he's like, okay, I know this one needs to be small as well. And the other small amount in his mind was 0. And to me, that was huge. I wasn't going to correct him and be like, no, buddy, that you can't do that, right? This is the first time he's been exposed to this model. I want him to just get a feel of the model and have him use his own understanding for right now. So again, the model is still really abstract. I mentioned this in the video about number bonds, but it's really abstract because the kids don't see the actual objects. They're not seeing 10 things in there. So you want to start out with making it very concrete, and then you work to representing it, and then you move to the abstract. So again, you want to do all of these in the same activities. So a lot of times you'll be having them model with objects, have them draw some kind of visual, and then attach the symbols to it. So what that might look like is, let's say they've got their counting cubes out, and they've modeled this, and again, we want to line it up because guess what, guys? The other powerful part of this model is that it connects to another really, really powerful model, which is the number line or a number path for young kiddos. So if you're not familiar with a number path, I'll also link to a video I've done about number paths and why we should be using number paths with our kindergarten and most of our first grade kiddos instead of number lines. In these examples, I do show number lines, but just know with kiddos that are young, we are using number paths instead of number lines. So they've modeled this, they've shown 2 and 4, okay, and then we're drawing that. I'm doing a visual representation of that, and I might even attach the whole, so do a visual of the 2 and 4, but also a visual of the 6. So we want them to see the parts that come together to make the whole. It's not just 2 and 4, it is 2 and 4, but 2 and 4 make 6. So we got to reference both of those pieces, the parts and the whole. And then the cool part again is that we can draw a number line right underneath that, or if you're using a number path, have them model the same thing on a number path, okay, and have them see the 2 and the 4 that come together to make the 6. The power of the bar model is, and these part whole models, is that they're linear, and that linear leads into number paths and number lines. So even as we work forward with our kids with fractions, you can still be modeling it concretely. Okay, and then we'll draw, like just trace right around it, attach those symbols to that drawing, and then again, you can attach another model to it. Help them make the connection between that model and other models that they are using. It's super, super powerful. And the coolest part is that you can use these models for all kinds of mathematics. Here's a visual where they're concretely modeling multiplication, right? They're showing three groups of three concretely. We can attach the bar model to it. Okay, and then we can attach the number line to show the whole. 3, 3, and 3 becomes 3, 6, 9 as the whole. The coolest part is that they're getting the proportionality, they're connecting it to other really powerful models, and they're able to use their intuitive sense with this that they can't with a lot of other models. Now, really quickly, I wanted to show you, because here's the thing I don't recommend. Do not go out on the internet and go search for part whole models, because most of them that you will find are not proportional. Every single one of them will look like this first one. And the power of this model is that we want to change the parts so that they are proportional. That's the big thing. So a lot of the downloads that you're going to find are not proportional, which makes the model not intuitive. Okay, so the cool part, I just made these by taking shapes. I'm on a Mac, so I'm using Pages. If you have a Word document, find where your shapes are, create a rectangle. I drew one rectangle, and then I drew the smaller ones down here. And then the cool part is, now I can take that and I can drag it to make it a little bit different size. Whoops, that's the one that's underneath. Hang on a sec. Let me drag the other one. So you can just drag and make them different sizes based upon what you want the focus to be on. The other cool part is just have your document, and then you can change these out. If I want to change this, and now we're working with 24 here, okay? And then do different ones. You can make them as big as you want. You can have this be a fraction. I can have this be 3/4. Right? And then what are the parts here? You can put in the part here if you would like to do that. I could make this be 1/2, and it's not showing up because my font may be a little bit odd, but you guys get the picture. Like, I just want, all I'm doing is just making rectangles and putting text inside of those rectangles, and then you can change the size of those rectangles based upon whatever you want to be having them focus on. See, they're just rectangles. I got 2 rectangles there, and then I'm changing the size, lining them up so that they always end at the same spot there, but then you can adjust the size of them to be what you want, okay? So That's how you make your own. Don't rely upon the worksheets out there that are part whole, because most of them are incorrect representations, and we want to build that proportionality. That's super, super huge. All right, so I did title this an alternative to number bonds, but you guys, I think that this model is the alternative to number bonds. And I know that many of you might be tied to a curriculum that uses number bonds, and I just want to encourage you to replace number bonds with part whole bar models, because you're doing the exact same mathematics. It is not about the model. They do not have to put it into a number bond to perform on an assessment. Guys, it's not going to ask a kid and on a state test, double check your state test, but every state test I've seen does not say put this into a number bond. It wants kids to be able to decompose numbers and be able to compose numbers, put numbers together to create a whole. That's the big idea. And this model can be the alternative that you use to number bonds. I hope that this video has helped you build your math mind so that you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.